Hi, everyone. I am Go Chai Wat. This is the first time that I share my knowledge in English. Normally, I share my knowledge in Thai language. I would like to tell you that my English the English is not my native language. I think a lot for my English. I worry about the for vocabulary. Wrong vocabulary. I mean the sometimes present English is not good. However, please focus on what I would like to share you in the technical skill. This is that's only the title for me to present English. If it's good for you and it work for me, next video. Okay. Now, this video would like to focus on the packet life and encapsulation decapsulation. This is a concept only. The TCP, this focus on the TCP layer 2 is we call the network access, layer 3 internet, layer 4 is a transport, and the layer application layer. Normally switch work on the layer 2, I mean the basic device, not okay. Today switch have the layer 3 switch. Some router can work on the firewall. It can work like the firewall. Some firewall have the application capability to detect the application layer. However, this is a basic device, basic capability of the device. Okay, why the switch work on the layer 2? Basically, switch can read the Ethernet protocol, Ethernet header, and can read the MAC address and forward MAC address based on its MAC table. Why the router work on the layer 3? Because the router can read the IP header and can read the IP header and can understand the IP header, IP protocol, and it can read the destination IP address and forward IP packets based on its routing table. For the right now we not focus for the firewall. For the layer 2 and layer 3 MAC Ethernet protocol, IP protocol, it relay the forwarding data. For the layer for the TCP IP, for the transport layer and application layer, it relay with the end device. Endpoint device mean the IPC to PC. The transport layer represent the transport layer use the TCP port address, UDP port address to represent the data. It show that the data relate what the application. For example, TCP port number 80 is relate with the web application. The TCP port number 25 is relate with the mail application. Okay, I will show you the encapsulation and decapsulation for next slide. Now, PC A would like to send data to the PC B. It views this is the data. All of the data would like to transfer to the PC B. But in the network layer, it cannot transfer in the big data in the same time. It will use the pitch of data. Use the pitch of the data and put on the payload of the TCP header. This header will relate with the data. If this data is the web application, it will use the destination TCP. Is the part number 80. To show that, to tell the destination, tell the destination endpoint, to tell the PCB that the this data is the data of web application. Okay. After that, the TCP header, the switch, and the router cannot understand the TCP protocol and cannot understand the TCP address. Only the PC PC and destination PC. Only the PC can understand the TCP. How can PCA forward this packet, this bit of data to the PCB? It need to encapsulate to the IP header. And destination IP will focus on destination IP is the IP address of the PCB. And if this IP packet sent to the switch can understand only the Ethernet header. The switch cannot understand the IP header, IP protocol. So we need to encapsulate to another header is the Ethernet header. After data encapsulated to the until the layer 4, layer 3, until the layer 2, it will send out the PCA to the switch. The switch have the MAC address table. MAC table. Switch can know what where is the MAC X, where is the is port. Yeah. For example, yes, MAC X is a MAC Y. Switch is port number 1, port number 2. Normally switch have the MAC table. In the MAC table can it have the data in the MAC X is stored in the is in the port 1 of the MAC of the switch. The MAC is port 1 MAC X. The MAC Y is the attached to the port number 2, physical number port number 2 of the switch. For internet, okay. In the okay, someone ask me how switch know where is the MAC address. How switch know MAC address X attached in the port 1. How MAC address know? How switch know MAC address attached in the port 1. For this time, I don't discuss about the MAC address table. Okay. Switch can understand the Ethernet header, Ethernet protocol, and can read the destination MAC address. Okay. After Ethernet frame come to the switch, switch will read the MAC header. Will read the Ethernet header and read the MAC address, destination MAC address, and look up in its MAC table to find that where is the destination, where is the port need to forward. And then after it's found the destination MAC address, it will forward out of its MAC its interface that the destination is installed. After switch found destination MAC address in its MAC table and know that the destination attached what the port it will forward Ethernet frame to that port. For this example, forward this interface and the Ethernet frame go to the router. The router don't interest in the MAC address table. That's the router don't focus in the MAC address. It will in the Ethernet frame go to the router. The router don't focus on the Ethernet header. It will decapsulate the Ethernet header and focus on the IP header only, and it will read the destination IP address to look up on the on its routing table and find the destination. If it found the destination, it check the outgoing interface. It will check the its outgoing interface, and then it will forward IP packet to the destination outgoing interface. However, the layer 3, the IP packet cannot send directly because sometimes we may have the switch in the path. The router need to encapsulate the Ethernet header again and then forward to the destination. For this example, we don't have the switch for this hop. Okay. The Ethernet frame is will forward to the PCB. Now, this Ethernet frame store this Ethernet frame coming to the PCB already. PCB will check the destination magnet. That destination magnet, that is destination magnet, will check its will check Ethernet header, check the destination magnet. If it the destination magnet is the magnet, it is the magnet, it will accept. If the destination magnet is not its magnet, it will discard this frame. Now, for example, assume that destination magnet is magnetable. It will decapsulation, and then it will read the destination IP. If destination IP is IP address, it will accept and the encapsulation. After that, it need to check. It need to know the data related. What is application? It need to read TCP header and read the destination TCP port. If the port number, destination port number 80, is know that the data related with the web application, and then it get the piece, the first piece of data for the next piece data. It will process in the same first packet, but for this step, I would like to show is transfer like this. This transferring is like a peer forwarding. For the transport and application layer, it will be focused by the PC only. This is a peer layer. For the layer 3 IP and Ethernet, it's focused on the switch at the router. Okay, I will finish for present this video. Please, if it's good for you and it's good for me and work for me, I may create the next video for you. Thank you for watching.